story. So apparently the homophobe was a big mad at Justin Bieber and Jaden Smith for showing affection to each other at the at Coachella. Now, is it gay for two men to show affection towards each other? Apparently it is, I guess. So it's so there's a video that went viral. Our longtime friends Justin Bieber and Jaden Smith sharing a cute moment backstage at Coachella Valley Music and Arts Festival. Smith was captured hugging Bieber from behind. Yeah, I like hugging dudes from behind too, but we all know what that leads to. And sharing a harmless dance moment with him before the singer kissed Smith on the cheek. No matter what you think about the Never Say Never duo, of which Smith's rap verse lives rent-free in our heads, there's no excuse for the onslaught of homophobic hate the pair received. Now, in case y'all didn't see it, I do have the clip of the video, little short video. You know, they had, what's his name? I think the Shade Room, but I'm like, was y'all really expecting, you know, pro queerness from the Shade Room? All their replies on that channel is website. Well, not even a website. First of all, they don't even have do they have a website? I think they do. But mostly that should be on Instagram. But anyway. So I'll never say never. I will fight till forever. So apparently, like I said, people are big mad over Justin Bieber and them and that whole situation. And it's like, well, you know, I'm surprised. I find it funny that people are more upset over that. And I'm realizing that is that drugs that Justin Bieber is holding in his hand? Probably a blunt or something of that nature. Because I saw the lighter was lit, but he was about to smoke something. I wouldn't be surprised if Jada be smoking that shit too. I mean, didn't Jada say that he introduced her to what's that that type of drug that opens up your chakras in your mind or whatever when she was going through her stuff with hunching his friend, you know, August Alsina. So the biggest took to Twitter to rinse the childhood friends from their interaction, even trying to use the word gay as a slur. Beneath the repost of the video from the Shade Room, some comments read, "When did grinding on each other become the new greeting between men? Can we go back to a handshake, please?" And a Bieber back hug followed by a Smith smooch is freaky word. Advocates for the LGBTQ plus community have the last word, however. "They've known each other since they were kids. Get over it," one person responded, while another added in reference to the pair, "From the comments, it seems the only time we feel men are real men is when they're shooting each other and violent." Others noted how it's generally more socially acceptable for women to kiss their friends without stigma or shame. "Society is such double standard is terrible," one commenter rightfully said. "So much bigotry in the comments, men are allowed to be affectionate. Not that their actions, which are pretty acceptable, need to be justified, but Bieber and Smith have been friends for over a decade. They first collaborated in 2010 with their theme song for the reboot of The Karate Kid and have been friends since." And look, Bieber is, you know, he's never identified with the community. He's been married to Haley since 2018. There was a point where Justin called Jaden his boyfriend. I remember hearing that. And then at one point, Jaden referred to, who did he refer to as? He referred to somebody else as his boyfriend. Who was it? I forgot. Was it Tyler, the Creator? We just talked about him. At a festival, I think that's when he referred to him as his man. And I think a lot of people also will bring up the video where Justin Bieber was seen at a club with Trey Songz and a bunch and Odell Beckham, and it looked like that Justin was giving Odell sloppy toppy. There's that video floating around. And then it wasn't that recently Jaguar Wright. Child, yeah, you know, she stay on the platforms. I think she was on Storm Monroe show. She was on somewhere. I didn't watch it. But I saw it was trending from some people that I be following. And they was talking about how she alluded to the fact that Diddy may have done some things to Justin Bieber. So I may have to look into that and come with y'all with further receipts. But I would not be surprised. I mean, I also think he touched Usher. Based on him having sleepovers at 14 at a grown man house. Well, he might have been younger than that. So to me, it's like, I don't mind the whole affection thing. If guys want to show affection toward each other, go ahead and do that. I don't think they're gay. If they are, they are. If they decide to come out tomorrow, congratulations. Welcome to the family. But I like the idea that the younger generations are trying to kill. This is the one thing I will give Gen Z. A lot of y'all are trying to kill those stigmas in regards of a lot of the toxic masculinity from my generation and the generation before that, and even some of the millennials. I do see like a lot of the younger kids are feeling freer to live their non-binary lives and to be out here wearing, like I be seeing boys wearing skirts and stuff out in the streets and stuff in New York without a fuck of a care in the world, especially if you go to Bushwick. Bushwick is very fluid when it comes to the how you doings. And I do see a lot of the changes and stuff happening. So I will give Gen Z that. Like y'all are really up in the situation when it comes to y'all are killing those stigmas in regards of, you know, guys are young men are challenging the status quo in regards of showing affection. And I've been to places where even I've been to like when I'm working in the garden, I've seen guys who meet up with their guy friends and they're hugging and giving kisses and stuff. Italians all the time. Italians kiss each other on the cheek. You got and I do have Italians in my family. I also have I've also seen like what would be the proper, is it Muslim, Arabic, whatever, like I've seen, there was one video I just saw floating on social media of men greeting each other and give like a peck on the lips, and it's basically a term of endearment. It's a form of affection, like greeting your friend. It's not sexual. So anytime you see man on man, because American society has created this whole thing, and a lot of y'all lack education in regards of cultures, this is what y'all do. And especially when y'all posting this shit on places like the Shade Room, you know what that audience gives, or the people that go on that website or on Instagram and they comment, is black folks. A lot of people in black communities don't even have a sense of history when it comes to their own stuff. We had to create, because our history has been destroyed by white people and slave owners and all this other stuff. Black people don't have anything to look at in the past in regards of culture. So we had to, you know, create our own thing. We had to develop and create our own thing in order for us to have something, because a lot of our history has been diluted and destroyed. So there's that.